Are you getting Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 DirectX error? DirectX encountered an unrecoverable error. Then you are at the right place. We have got some easy ways that you can use to fix this issue. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Download DirectX from the Microsoft website. Open your web browser and paste the link to download DirectX from the Microsoft website. Click on the download button and click on the .exe file when done. Click on Yes from the USE prompt to allow. Accept the agreement and click on the Next button. Uncheck the Install the Bing Bar checkbox. Again click on Next. Wait till the installation process is completed. Click on Finish and restart your PC. Once the system restarts, launch the game and check. Method 2. Update graphics drivers. Next, you can update your graphics drivers. Right-click on the Windows Search button and choose Device Manager. Go to the Display Adapters section and then expand it. Right-click on your graphics driver and click on the Update Driver option. Select the Search Automatically for Drivers option and follow the instructions provided on screen to download and install the latest driver. You should visit the official websites of your graphics card manufacturer to update the graphics card drivers. These websites are linked in the description below. Download the latest drivers for the graphics card installed on your computer from these websites. Follow the on-screen instructions to complete the driver installation process. Method 3. Verify the game files. To verify the game file, go to the Steam library and right-click on the game. Then open its properties. Go to the Install Files tab and select the Verify Integrity of Game Files option. After the verification, launch the game and check. Tweak some in-game settings. Before you tweak settings, make sure the game is closed. Click on This PC, then open the Documents folder. Navigate to the COD Game Installation folder. Inside that, you will find the Players folder. Rename the Players folder. Like here, we have named it as Players 1. You can also delete the folder. This will recreate the folder when you launch the game for the next time. Method 5. Close other programs running in the background and disable Steam overlay. Sometimes due to program conflicts, you can have the error. So make sure no other program is running in the background. Also, make sure that the Steam overlay feature is disabled as this can help improve gaming performance. Open Steam and click on Library. Find Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 and right-click on it. Then select its properties. From the General tab, uncheck the Enable the Steam Overlay while in-game option. Also, disable other overlay apps like GeForce Experience, Discord, Nvidia ShadowPlay Overlay or AMD Overlay. Method 6. Uncheck compatibility from Steam and game .exe file. To do so, first exit Steam. Then type Steam in the Windows search box and right-click on it. Select Open File Location. From here, right-click on Steam once again. Select Properties. Go to the Compatibility tab. Uncheck the box for Run this program in compatibility mode for option. Click on Apply and then click on OK. Then launch the game and check. Do the same for the game .exe file. For that, go to the Steam installation folder from Steam. Go to Steam library. Right-click on the game. Select Manage, then click on Browse Local Files. It will take you to the Game Installation folder. Find the Game .exe file, right-click on it, select Properties. Go to the Compatibility tab. Uncheck the box for Run this program in compatibility mode for option. Click on Apply and then click on OK. Next, scroll up and open the SP23 folder. Repeat the same for the game .exe file inside it. Again, go back and open the SP22 folder and repeat the same process. Once done, launch the game and check. Method 7. Let the shader's optimization be 100% complete. While launching the game, if you see shader's optimization at the top left side, then let it be 100%. Then launch the game. Method 8. Allow the game.exe file through Windows Security. Allow the game.exe file to Windows Security and Firewall. Windows Security and Firewall can be extra protective sometimes and interfere with your game. So allow the game through Windows Security or any antivirus program you are using and then launch the game. Type Windows Security in the Start menu and press Enter. Select Virus and Threat Protection. Click on Manage Settings. Scroll down to the Exclusion section. Click on Add or Remove Exclusions. Click on Yes in the UAC prompt. Click on the Add an Exclusion button and select File. Navigate to the Game Installation folder and select the game .exe. Click on Open. Also add the .exe file from the SP23 folder. Method 9. Add -dx11/d3d11/dx12 in the launch options. Go to the Steam library, right-click on the game and open its properties. Go to the General tab. In the Launch option, type DX11 and then launch the game. If this doesn't work, enter -d3d11 or -dx12 in the Launch options and check. Method 10. Run the game as an administrator from the Game Installation folder. The game may require administrative privileges to run, so right-click on the game from the Steam library and select Manage. Then click on Browse Local Files. It will take you to the Game Installation folder. Find the game.exe file and right-click on it. Go to the Compatibility tab. Check the Run this program as an administrator box. Click on Apply, then OK. If that doesn't work, then open the SP23 folder. Then find the game.exe file and choose to run it as an administrator. Method 11. Try windowed mode. If you are able to launch the game, try launching it in windowed mode. Go to the game settings, select the graphics tab. Change the display mode to windowed mode. You can select a lower resolution for the game. Then scroll down and turn off the VSync. Go down and turn off NVIDIA Reflex Low Latency. Apply the settings and check the performance now. Method 12. Reinstall the game. If nothing is working, uninstall and reinstall the game. Right-click on the game from Steam library and select Manage. Select Uninstall. Once done, go to the Game Installation folder and delete it. Once you delete it, reinstall the game to a different drive and check if the issue is fixed. We hope one of these methods has worked for you. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.